Do you ever just feel like you're shooting in the dark when you're trying to learn how to eat intuitively and live with no food rules? Yeah, I did too. Today, I'm gonna share with you my 5 intuitive eating book recommendations to get you started on actually getting it. And then at the end, I'm going to give you a little bonus recommendation, and it's probably my favorite book of all time, and you'll see why. Yes, it beats out Harry Potter. Total nerd status. So these 5 books are the 5 books that I started with when I started living with no food rules and working towards intuitive eating. Okay, so I did a mix of reading them and listening to them. Thank you, Audible. So if you're not a big reader, be sure to stick around. I'll link to that below. Audible's so fabulous, guys. I'm obsessed. But you can totally go traditional book route too. Okay, so the first book recommendation that I have for you guys is actually the OG intuitive eating book. Now, this is where I recommend that you guys start because, like I said, it is literally the book on intuitive eating. P.S. I'm going to be linking to all these books in the description, so don't feel like you have to screenshot them or anything like that. I'll give you easy links. So this book really walks you through the 10 principles that are the foundation of intuitive eating. It was written by 2 dietitians, and it's just an absolutely amazing book. I honestly stumbled upon it in the library on a whim, and I can't tell you how much this book changed my life. It is really what has allowed me to truly live a life where I'm not obsessed with food or my weight or my body. I live. This book is like square one. I recommend you start here. Now, for all my Audible lovers out there, I don't love the Audible version. I have both the paper copy and the Audible version. If you are an Audible listener, you know that the narrator really makes or break the book. And honestly, I had a really hard time listening to it, so I do recommend the paper version just for that. Plus, you can take notes during it and highlight things, earmark things. My copy is like all marked up. So the second book that I have for you is actually the Intuitive Eating Workbook. And this one really goes hand in hand with the Intuitive Eating book. Now, it's not a book that you sit down and read from cover to cover. I think it's more of a book. It has a lot of practical exercises in it, and I think it's kind of a long-term book that you're going to want to keep. I think it's a really great continual resource. Even after you really start to get the hang of intuitive eating, you really start to understand listening to your body. This intuitive eating workbook is going to help you to cement that when diet culture messaging might get a hold of you, because it's natural to have some of those thoughts every now and again, because that messaging is everywhere, whether we want to see it or not. It's kind of a good, I guess you say, reality check to kind of keep doing. So I highly recommend getting this book. I actually got a copy. I found it at my local library again. If you are like, Colleen, I'm not going to sit here and go buy all these books, look at your local library, you guys. It's fabulous. So again, you do not need to sit down and go through every single exercise in the book, but it's a good resource to do over time. Maybe you pick one a week. Maybe you pick a couple a week just to get that ball moving, get that momentum going, and give yourself some sort of guidance. I feel like a lot of people, my past self included, do kind of just shoot in the dark and hope for the best, when it's going to be so much more efficient if you actually sit down and have some thought behind it, like using this intuitive eating workbook. Fabulous resource. Okay, so the third book that I have for you is called Body Kindness. I love this book. I've listened to it 3 times, and it's narrated by the author Rebecca. She's also a dietitian. Love it. She has a really great voice to just listen to. That sounded strange, but you know what I mean. She's really easy to listen to. It's not like someone's talking at you. It's pretty conversational. So highly recommend Audible for that one. What I really, really love about Body Kindness is that Rebecca really marries the topics of intuitive eating and really caring for your health into one, and paints this big picture of body kindness in the physical sense, in the mental sense, in the emotional sense. And she really marries everything together. And I think a lot of people forget about those other pieces and they just focus on overcoming their fear of cheeseburgers and not feeling guilty over that when there's so much more to it. A lot of people think that you can't care about your health while eating intuitively, and that is just not true, you guys. And I think that Rebecca spells it out really, really well throughout this book. She walks you through body kindness in the food sense, your food choices and nutrition. She walks you through exercise. I really like that piece of it because I know a lot of people who struggle with food also struggle with exercise, because those two definitely do have their overlap, whether it's you're over-exercising because you're trying to burn off the food, or maybe you have no exercise routine. She really does kind of tackle both of those. So I like that aspect of it. And she also does focus on the mental mental health side of things. So I think that those things just really work together to create this, like she says, body kindness and to really be able to listen to your body. I think this is a great intuitive eating book recommendation for anyone who is looking to start in that space. This is a really good book to kind of show those nuances. Now, the fourth book that I have for you is called Beyond Beautiful. This is what it looks like. Ah, so good. So this book is body image based. It does not specifically target food, but my no food rules philosophy for nutrition, for eating, for health also focuses on body image. So I really have these three pillars of the no food rule philosophy, and those are mindset, breaking your food rules, and body image. I truly believe that all three of those things need to be really the focus of your work in order to find a life of food freedom. Because think about it. I don't personally think that you can have a healthy relationship with food if you don't have a healthy relationship with what you're putting that food into. So I highly recommend this Beyond Beautiful book for anyone who's working into the intuitive eating, no food rules space. I really like that this book shares actual snippets of women's real words. And I mean, honestly, I'm reading it and half the time I'm like, I could have said that. There are these really powerful quotes throughout the book, and it makes you feel not alone. It makes you feel understood, and it really normalizes the body image struggles that so many of us have. I really also like that the pages are color coordinated. So sometimes what I'll do, to be honest, is I believe it's the yellow pages that are the practical exercises that she talks about. And I mean, sometimes if I'm just having a rough body image day, because guys, I have those too. My body image is not perfect by a long shot. We all struggle. So sometimes on those days, what I'll like to do, I always keep this book nearby. It's always in my office. And I will just grab that book, flip to one of the yellow pages, do one of the exercises to give myself a little bit of a pick-me-up. Even when you read it, I did read it cover to cover. It's a really great resource to be able to come back to. Just read some of those words from real women that make you feel like you're understood, that make you feel like you're not alone, and then dive into some of those exercises when you just need a pick-me-up. And this book is a super duper easy read. It's actually really enjoyable and kind of funny. Okay, so the fifth intuitive eating book recommendation that I have for you is Health at Every Size. This book is for all of you guys who always ask me, okay, Colleen, where'd you get that information? Where did you get that cited from? This book is for you. It talks a lot of science, but it is totally mind-blowing. It really debunks how much we associate our weight and our size with our health. I really recommend this book to anyone, no matter what size you are. Okay, I listened to this one too. It's definitely not a beach read by any means. I'd recommend listening to it like on your commute or something like that, not when you need like a pick-me-up or like before bed. Maybe before bed. It can be a little dry, but it's very, very based in science and they talk about a lot of studies. No matter what size you are, I recommend that you read this book because a lot of our issues with food and our fear around food stems from our weight. And this book really helps to alleviate the pressure of our weight being the only determinant of our health. And what I really loved about this book was that, okay, a lot of people think that, okay, I'm just gonna eat cheeseburgers all day long. That is intuitive eating. But they actually talk about the nutrition behind it and how you can apply it in a way that is gentle and it's not these rules. So if you are curious about Health at Every Size, highly recommend getting this book. You can either, I would say either would be good, either the hard copy or the Audible version. I definitely did a lot of clips on my version on Audible, which is also a really nice aspect of Audible. Oh, this book is just so good, you guys. It talks a lot about science if you're interested in that. Talks a lot about the health aspect if you are interested in that. And again, for anyone who struggles with their weight, their body image, no matter what size, I highly, highly recommend this book. Okay, now for the bonus book. So the book that I recommend is Lucky. Let me explain. So this again is not a book focused on food, but this is a book that's focused on mindset. And like I said, that is one of the really three pillars of my no food rules philosophy: mindset, breaking food rules, and body image. So she talks a lot about the law of attraction and manifestation. And I'll be honest with you guys, I was totally one of those people who were like, that is all fairies and pixie dust crap. And I did not believe it. But this book totally changed my mind. It rocked my world. It is amazing. It changed everything. And everything that she talks about can be directly related to food and your relationship with it. It really talks about our thoughts and how those impact our life and the things that we do. Oh, it's so good. It's fascinating. Plus, she has a really, really great accent, and I've I honestly feel like listening to her is like listening to butter. Like, it's just so good. It's so comforting. And I cannot tell you how many times I've listened to this book. It is insane. Oh, is her voice. Definitely recommend the Audible version of it as well as the paper copy. But the content is so good. Her voice is so good. It might be my favorite book of all time because it's like listening to butter, but also because it honestly changed my life. Plus, this lady is funny as heck. And you guys know I love good humor. All right, guys, there you have it. Those are my 5 intuitive eating book recommendations, as well as that little bonus book that I gave you guys. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like it and subscribe to the channel down there. It really does help to support my channel and allow me to spread this message of living with no food rules. I will see you guys next Sunday. 5 p.m. Eastern time is when new videos are uploaded, so I'll see you then.